Listen to the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor with a dielectric slab in between the two plates. Right? See all the equations once. See. Now, we want to see the different case of this capacitance. Now, this first case, case one, if, suppose here, this will be the total free space. In this free space, suppose there, if we introduce the whole dielectric material, means what we get there? If T, which is equal to the D, it means that the thickness of this this dielectric slab is nothing but the distance between these two plates. Then at that time, how much amount of capacitance is produced of this capacitor? We want to see that. So what we get that? Now we want to substitute this value here. So what we get there? C, which is equal to the this A. Epsilon 0 is as it is, right? Here D, which is also as it is, but instead of T, we want to substitute the D. So minus D, then plus D upon K. So what to get there? Plus minus get cancelled. So here simply we get, what to get there? D upon K. But again, this K is at denominator of the denominator, so transfer to numerator. So C, which is equal to the what to get there? A epsilon 0 K upon simply D. So this will be the formula of capacitance with dielectric. Right? So this will be the first case. Now we want to see the second case. Suppose there, if we divide this distance by the number of different dielectric slabs of thickness is there, suppose the T1, T2, T3, T4, just like this one. It means that this capacitor, this will be the original capacitor, right? So this will be the earthing. Then this space, which is filled by the different dielectric slabs. Suppose this is the first one, their dielectric constant is K1 and distance is there, suppose their T1. That is the thickness is T1. Here thickness is T2, their dielectric constant is K2. Then this will be the T3 and now this will be the K3. In this way, suppose there, if you introduce the n number of slabs, right, then the effective capacitance of this capacitor is C, which is equal to the, here we want to use the same formula. So what we get there? This A epsilon 0 is as it is. Here D is as it is, but the value of T is nothing but the D, because of here we want to introduce the number of slab in a whole space. So that's why the value of T is nothing but the D. So what we get there? So this D minus D, which is cancelled. Simply here what we get there? T upon K. But here the thickness of different slabs are there different. Again, there are dielectrics, which is also different. So that's why here this formula, which is written as T1 upon K1 plus T2 upon K2 plus dot dot plus what you get there? Tn upon what you get there? Simply Kn. Right? So this will be the formula of the effective capacitance if the space, that is the free space of this capacitor, which is filled by the different dielectric slab. Now this is the second case. Now we want to see the third case. What we get there? Third case. Suppose here, if we divide the area of this capacitor, then what we get there? In this case, when we divide the distance, then this will be the series combination. But when we divide the area, then that combination of capacitor called as the parallel split capacitors. That is the parallel combination, right? So for parallel combination, here we get the what you get there. Their area, if that area which is divided into the what you get there, A1, then A2, then simply An. So what you get there? But the addition of all these areas is nothing but the A. Then at that time, the formula of the capacitance is, we know that the formula of the capacitance in parallel combination, what you get there? C which is equal to the what you get there? C1 plus C2 plus C3 plus dot dot plus Cn. Right? Then the value of first capacitor, it means that suppose that this will be the first plate and now this will be the second plate. Now this will be the first, now they are dielectric slab, this will be the second one, this will be the third one, fourth one, and suppose this will be the nth one. Right? Here area of this one is their A1, this will be the A2, this will be the A3. Simply here what you get there? An. So this will be the positive plate. So this will be the positive potential and now this will be the earthing. Then such a combination is nothing but the parallel combination. Then simply we want to substitute the value of C1, C2. For the first capacitor, their value is what you get there? Charge. Or instead of charge, there we want to use the simple equation what you get there? Epsilon 0 upon D. Their distance is as it is. This distance we keep as it is. Simply here we divide the area. So that's why here what you get there inside the bracket. Again, we want to use the same formula. Right? So their area is divided. As for that, their dielectric constant, which is also changes. So what you get there? Then at that time, for the first capacitor, this is the A1, K1. For the second capacitor, A2, K2 plus dot dot plus nth dielectric slab. What you get there? An into the Kn. Right? So this is about the last case. What happened here? Here, this area of the this capacitor plate, which is divided into the A1, A2, A3, An. It means that here we use the different dielectric slab. Then at that time, their effective capacitance is C, which is equal to the epsilon 0 upon D inside the bracket A1, K1 plus A2, K2 plus dot dot plus An, Kn. Right? See all the equations.